Hello students, good morning everyone. So till now in our previous classes we have completed our second unit. Today we are going to start unit 3. So coming to unit 3, in unit 3 you have two chapters. Our unit 3 is about demand analysis and index numbers. So in today's class, today we are going to start the first part of the unit 3, that is demand analysis. So demand analysis, first we'll start the introduction to the demand analysis. So it's a very small topic only, demand analysis. So demand analysis means analyzing about the demand. So we will be having demand for any product or a particular commodity. So how to analyze the demand, everything what comes under demand, we will be studying in the demand analysis. So nowadays to formulate the major economic policies. So in economics, to formulate the different policies and to maintain a balance in the economy, the demand analysis is mostly used. So this demand analysis mainly consists of the two aspects. So there are two aspects for the demand analysis. First one is the relationship between the market price and demand. The relationship between the market price and the demand. The first aspect is the relationship between the market price and the demand on the basis of the time series data. So what is the relationship between the market price? So suppose in a, what is the price of a commodity in the market? So how it is related to the demand? That means how the price is affecting the demand will be studied. That is, as a result of price control is the demand for the particular commodity will control within the limits of the supply. So how to control this demand within the given price and within the given supply of the commodity? So I can supply only some goods, up to 100 goods. So within that supply, how to maintain the price and demand of the commodity is the first aspect. Or to whether the given market price is correct for the correct for the available supply or not, or whether we have to increase the market price or decrease the market price can be known by using the demand analysis. And the second one is based on the gradual changes in the income level. Gradual changes in income level. So how demand affects by in respect to the income level. So suppose if our income level is high, we will be earning more money, right? So if we earn more money, obviously we go for buying the products. So that means if the income increases, the demand for the particular product also increases. Suppose if income decreases, the demand also decreases. So in this case, the gradual changes in the income level also affects the demand. So demand analysis, it is basically based on two aspects. The first one is the relationship between the market price and the demand. The second one, the gradual changes in the income level. So before knowing about the demand analysis or what are the different definitions, first we'll study what are the different types of goods. So first we will be, you know these goods already. We have studied, from past years we have studied, you know all these words, but just a reminder. First one is necessaries. The prime So next type is conventional goods. Conventional goods means the items which are not primary goods but are required by the convention. So what does convention mean? Convention means the habit. So here these are not the basic necessities, but they are habituated to have it. Now some people will be having a habit of having a coffee or tea in the morning. If they don't drink the coffee or tea, they feel incomplete. So like that, some people will be having the habit of reading the newspaper. So if they don't read the newspaper, they feel distressed. So like that, the goods which are needed according to the convention or the habit, which are not the primary needs, the primary goods, are called the conventional goods. So these are the three types of goods we have. That is necessaries, that means which are the primary things which are necessary to survive. That is food, shelter and clothes. Coming to luxuries, which are needed according to our luxuries. And convention means the goods which are habituated by the nature. It depends on the individual persons. Now we will see the definitions of the demand and supply. So what is demand and what is supply? We will see now. So the demand for any commodity means the requirement of an item. So when you will say a product is having a demand, when a person requires it. So the requirement of a product is called the demand. Requirement of a product is called as a demand. So if we require the product, that means there is a demand for that product. So this demand, it depends on the various factors. So what are the different factors which influence the demand? That means on which factors the demand is dependent. So the demand is dependent on the many number of factors. Like we know it is dependent on price. So if price increases, the demand decreases. If the price decreases, the demand increases. So the change in price affects the demand. So it is one of the factors responsible for the changes in demand. And another thing is income. So I said before also, if our income increases, then they decide to have that product. Then only the demand also increases. If the income is low, I may not desire that product, and at the same time, the demand also decreases. So even income plays the major role in the demand. And the price of other commodities also. So whenever you are going to buy something, mostly we will compare it. Whenever you have two things, whichever is having less price, we will see that. Cheap and best quality we will see. So we want the good item in the less price. So whatever the product, you have two products, A and B. You want to buy A, but comparatively with B price is less. Both are having same features, so but B price is less. So what we will do? We will buy B. So obviously if I buy B, the decrease in the demand for A. So the price of the other commodities also affect the demand. Now coming to the supply. So the increase in demand for a particular commodity does not mean an increase in the desired item, but it implies the desire to have it. So just a desire to have it, now demand means not taking that product or buying that product. The desire for having the product only implies the demand. Now supply. So what is supply? We know what is supply. Supply means the amount of commodity available. Amount of commodities available. between the demand and the different factors influencing the demand. So I said there are different factors which influence the demand, right? So what are those factors? Like price, income and prices of other commodities. So if you write a functional relationship between the demand for a commodity and the different factors influencing the demand for that commodity, it is called as the demand function. So basically, suppose D is the quantity demanded. D is the quantity demanded. Then the functional relationship is given as D equals to F of T. So here I am considering the function of P. That means the functional relationship between the demand and P indicates the price of the commodity. So here I am writing the functional relationship in terms of demand and the price. So demand is a function of price. So generally, demand not only depends on price, it is influenced by the other things also, like income, consumer taste and the other factors. So I can write it as D equals to, or dx equals to f of L comma C comma P y comma t. So here L indicates the price of the commodity. So generally I say demand depends on the price of the commodity. So first thing is I am writing the functional relationship between the demand and what are the different factors. First one is price. C indicates the consumer interest. So how much a consumer is interested to buy the product, or the how much is willing to buy that product. P indicates the price of the other commodities. So demand depends on the price of the other commodities also, right? Not only that particular commodity, the other commodity price also influences the demand. So P is price of other commodity. Here Y indicates the income of the consumer. Income of the consumer. And the last T indicates the taste of the consumer. So according to his wish, taste means whatever he wish, it depends on him. So obviously demand depends on the taste of the consumer. So if I consider the different five factors, I can write the demand function as dx equals to f of L comma C comma P comma Y comma T. Or simply we will be finding the functional relationship in terms of price only, because the major effect will be the price only. So generally we will be writing D equals to F of P as the demand function. So this is a demand function. And coming to the next, demand curve. So for this demand function, if you draw a curve, that is called as a demand curve. Now how will we be having the demand curve? Coming to demand curve, that means first you are writing a function, right? A relationship in terms of the mathematical function. So a curve fitted to the collection of the statistics on the transactions. That means you will be having different prices, P values and D values, demand. At a particular price, how much is the demand? At a particular price, how much is the demand? So by using this prices, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4. So if price increases, the demand decreases, right? The demand is 15 here. Here the demand falls to 46. Here the demand falls to 40. And again if price increases, the demand totally falls to 25. So like this, if demand increases, the price increases, the demand comes down. So for this, if you fit a mathematical curve or a curve is fitted, here we have written d equals to f of t. It is a curve, right? It is a function. So for that, if you fit a curve, you will be getting a graph, right? That is nothing but is called as the Riemann curve. So how will you get the Riemann curve? So on the x-axis we will be taking the price, on the y-axis we will be taking the demand for the particular commodity. So if you observe, keep on, if the price is increasing, the demand will decrease. So we will be getting a downward trend, that is in this way. So if demand, if the price keep on decreasing or increasing, the demand keep on decreasing. So this is the curve for the demand curve, where here this is nothing can be written as d equals to f of t. Since we are writing the demand curve function in terms of price. So this is about the demand function and demand curve. Now we'll study about the supply function and the supply curve. y are equal is determine the intersection of the two curves. So sometimes the market price will be settling down at a particular price. So that means both the demand and supply curves intersect. So this is the demand curve and this is the supply curve, right? So at a particular point P or a particular price P, both the demand curve P equals to F of P and supply curve is equals to phi of P, these both intersect. So this at a particular market price, the both demand and the market, sorry, demand and the supply curve intersects. So that is called as the equilibrium price. Equilibrium price means both the demand and supply curves intersection point, the price at which demand and supply intersect. So at this price, the both demand and supply curves meet. That means the price is equal for the demand and the supply. So this price is called as the equilibrium price. So remember what is demand, what is supply, what is equilibrium price and all. Now here, nothing but how to get the solution is here D equals to S. The condition for equilibrium price is D equals to S. That is demand curve is equals to the supply curve into capital D, right? So D equals to S, that means demand curve is equals to demand equals to supply. Now we'll see a small problem related to the equilibrium price. Coming to the question, the demand and supply curves of a commodity are given as D equals to, we write capital D equals to 19 minus 3P minus P square and S equals to 5P minus 1. So these two are the demand and the supply curves respectively. Now we have to find the equilibrium price. So coming to the equilibrium price condition, what is the condition for the equilibrium price? The solution is that D equals to S. What is the D value given in the question? 90 minus 3P minus P square equals to, what is the S value? 5P minus 1. Now solve this equation to get the equilibrium price. So 90 minus 3P minus P square minus 5P plus 1 equals to 0. So that we will be getting the value as 19 plus 1 is 20 minus minus 3P plus 5 minus 3P minus 5P is minus 8P minus P square equals to 0. So if I take minus common, I will be getting the equation as P square plus 8P minus 20 equals to 0. So this is the equation we got. Now how to solve this equation? Do the factorization. 20, right? So 10 2s are 20, 10 minus 2 is 8. So you can write 10 minus 2, P square plus 10P minus 2P minus 20 equals to 0. Now take P common. You will get P plus 10 minus 2 common, you will get P plus 10 equals to 0. So from this, P minus 2 equals to 0 or P plus 10 equals to 0. So from this b equals to plus 2 and here b equals to minus 10. So we got two values of price. If you observe, one is the positive value and another is the negative value. So price can never be negative. Price can never be negative. So since price can never be negative, therefore the equilibrium price is P equals to 2. So this is the price. So if they ask me how exchange, find the quantity exchange. So how to find the quantity means, quantity exchange is you have to substitute the P value either in D or either in S. So you have to find D at P equals to 2 or you can find S at P equals to 2. Since S is a small function, I consider that one. So that is, what is S value? 5P. 5P minus 1 at P equals to 2. So if you substitute 2, 5 is 10, 10 minus 1 is 9. So 9 is the quantity which is exchanged. So this is the first problem related to the